Good afternoon, everyone. Today's class, we will discuss about bond value theorems. So as you already know that in bond value theorems, there are five types or five theorems will come. So first one, that is theorem one, the bond prices move inversely to market interest rate changes, that is yield. Rise in market interest rate results into decrease in bonds price. The bond with low price has high yield because with lesser amount of money, more return is earned. So this theorem can understand by way of analyzing this table. So particulars, bond A, bond B. So in particulars column, par value. For bond A, it is rupees 1000. For bond B, it is rupees 1000. In particular column, that is coupon rate. For bond A, it is 10%. For bond B, it is also 10%. Maturity period for bond A, it is 2 years. For bond B, it is 2 years. Market price, again, it will change for bond A as well as for bond B. So for bond A, it is 874.75. For bond B, it is 1035.66. So yield we have to calculate. So already you know how to calculate yield. In previous problems, you understood how to calculate yield to maturity. So we have to put all these values in the formula. Then we will arrive at 17.13%. Okay, 17.13% for bond A. For bond B, it is 8%. So by analyzing these two, so bond A is greater than bond B yield. So bond A is preferred. So we can understand by way of analyzing this theorem one. So let us now understand what exactly theorem two is. Theorem two, the bond price variability is directly related to the terms to maturity, that is changes in bond prices are greater for long-term maturity. In other words, the bond with short-term to maturity sells at a lower discount than the bond with a long-term to maturity. So this theorem too can explain or understand by way of analyzing this table. Particulars, bond A, bond B. So par value for bond A is rupees 1000, for bond B also it is 1000. Coupon rate for bond A, it is 10%. For bond B, it is also 10%. Maturity period for bond A is 2 years. For bond B is 3 years. So yield for bond A is 15%. For bond B is 15%. Market price. So market price, we should calculate by way of putting values in this equation. So 100 divided by 1.15 raised to 1. Plus 100 plus 1000 divided by 1.15 raised to 2. So by putting or calculating this, we will arrive at rupees 918.71 for bond A. So same for bond B, we have to calculate, that is 100 divided by 1.15 raised to 1, 100 divided by 1.15 raised to 2, 100 divided by 1.15 raised to 3 plus 1000. So if we calculate this, we will arrive at 885.86. So market price by analyzing or comparing these two, that is bond A as well as bond B. So bond A is greater than bond B, hence bond A is preferred. So as well as, so while comparing with a discount for bond A or bond B, so rupees 81.29. So 1000 minus 918.71. So I already showed you how to calculate this premium as well as discount in previous problem. Okay, so 1000 minus 918.71, discount is 81.29 will be there for bond A. So for bond B, it is 114.14, that is 1000 minus 885.86. So by analyzing these two, bond A as well as bond B discount, so in bond B, we are getting, you know, 114.14, which is higher than bond A, that is 81.29. Hence, in this regard, we can prefer bond B. So in this, this is about theorem 2. So let us now understand what exactly theorem 3 is. Okay, so theorem 3, that is a bond's sensitivity to changes in market interest rate increases at a diminishing rate as the time remaining until its maturity increases. That is, the discount or premium amount will decrease at an increased rate as its life gets shorter. So we can understand this theorem 3 by way of analyzing this table. years to maturity, that is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. CF into PVIF, that is cash flow into present value interest factor at 10%. So cash flow, assume that it is 1000 for all the year. At 10%, for first year it is 0.9091, for second year it is 0.8264, for third year 0.7513, for fourth year 0.6830, for fifth year 0.6209. We have to multiply this cash flow into present value factor, we will arrive at these answers. So discount is this one. So by way of analyzing this table, we can understand this theorem 3. Okay. Last but one, that is theorem 4. That is the price changes resulting from equal absolute increase in the market interest rate are not symmetrical. That is, decline in market interest rate causes a price rise that is larger than the price decline resulting from an equal increase in market interest rate. So we can understand this theorem 4 by analyzing this example. Face value, that is 1000, maturity 5 years, coupon rate 10%, yield, that is 10%, 8% and 12%, market price 1079.87, 1927.92:2. Increase or decrease, there is no increase or decrease in this. For second one, 79.86. For third one, 72.22. So this is the theorem 4. This is about theorem 4. So last one, that is theorem 5. That is the bond price volatility is inversely related to the coupon rate. That is, smaller the coupon rate, greater will be the volatility of bond price. The percentage change in bonds price due to a change in market interest rate will be smaller if its coupon rate is higher and vice versa. So we can understand by way of analyzing this table. Particulars, bond A, bond B. So for par value, for A is rupees 100, for B also it is 100. Coupon rate interest for A is 10%, for B is 8%. Yield for A is 8%, for B is 8%. Maturity period, 3 years for A, 3 years for B also. Market price is 105.15 for bond A, rupees 100 for bond B. So yield rise 1% for bond A, 1% for bond B. Price after yield for bond A is rupees 102.53. So for bond B is 97.47. So by analyzing this table, we can understand theorem 5. Okay, thank you.